Peeps, Celine here, and welcome to a brand new Let's Play. I just downloaded this game and got it going. Oh. Okay. I gotta get it all set up as I get this cord under my keyboard so it doesn't irritate me. Controller vibrate. No. Blind sight animation. Sure. For a little bit. I'll have that on for a little bit. Subtitles are on. It's going to be English voice, English text, background music. So you guys can at least hear it. This is going to go down. Cutscene voices. We're going to do modern because this is the HD version. Full screen, no. Actually, it's fine what screen is on. No, I want it slightly bigger. It does not have my screen size. That's the problem. Yeah, that's good enough. That's big enough. Shadow buffer. I'm gonna put it times 2 so it doesn't lag too much. Yeah, we'll do English or medium. Cause that's stuff we can edit in battle. Alright, in game. Now, if I don't push anything, maybe it'll do the opening that I want you guys to see. Cause if not, I'll have to close the game, reopen it. So you guys see it then. Which I find bullshit. Na 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 na. Oh wait. I saved a screenshot. Didn't want a screenshot. How do I refresh it? Never mind. It's doing it on its own. Thank you. cute opening. Huh. And yeah, I don't know why there's a black screen around. Alrighty. New game. Earth level, because I'm, as you say, a kitty cat. Because I actually played on this, and I messed up. You guys can't even... Ugh. But this is basically normal. This is easy. I play on easy, because when I play on normal, I mess up. So for y'all's entertainment, it's going to be on easy. Because I actually tried to do hard.
AD 2064. Planet Earth was on the brink of destruction. Clashes between the World Republic Federation and the various nations that opposed it sparked the outbreak of World War III. Weapons of mass destruction, deployed with complete impunity, razed the land in the blink of an eye. People believed it was the end of the world. The dire situation forced the two opposing factions to negotiate a ceasefire, reaching an agreement in only 2 weeks. However, the war may have ended, but its effects remained. With the deteriorating environment, Earth's population was drastically reduced. Those who survived the conflict lived a confined existence, trapped in underground cities. Countries joined together to form the Greater United Nations and turned their eyes skyward to space. With the establishment of the USTA, or Universal Science and Technology Administration, man began to seek new worlds beyond the stars. AD 2087, the first year of the new space date calendar. Thanks to the success of Professor Trillis Bakhtine's warp drive experiments, mankind's dream inched ever closer to reality. The USTA secretly began to implement its SRF project, the Space Reconnaissance Force. Space Date 10, at last, the first official SRF mission. This moon base will be the start of our travels. I bet they're rehashing all this stuff at the ceremony. All right, guess I better be going.
This is Edge. Oh, I forgot she was entering.
I knew you'd be here.
Boy, I just can't get away from you, can I, Raimi?
How long do you think we've known each other? I know all your hiding places, Edge.
Yeah, you've been hanging on to me for as long as I can remember. Remember how you'd always cry when I wasn't around? Sure took the fun out of playing hide and seek with you.
That was ages ago. How long are you going to keep treating me like a child?
As long as you're so quick to flare up like that, I guess. If you're here, I guess the departure ceremony's over, huh? Anyway, there's still some time left until we take off. I'm gonna work out a few kinks in the battle simulator.
Sure. Hey, wait a second! You skipped the ceremony on purpose, didn't you?
Yeah, well, I thought I was gonna be able to meet a real hero. I might have gone if Commander Kenny was there, but Shimada's pontificating would just put me to sleep.
That's USTA Deputy Director Shimada to you.
Besides, I didn't want to see Crow gloating over his success anyway. It just really bugs me.
And you call me childish. You just better not be late for launch preparations, you hear?
She's our archer, by the way. So yeah, this is your base little tutorial type game. I don't care for it. I'd rather go for the main thing. So, more cutscenes! No, I actually like the cutscenes. But...
You imbecile! Are you trying to make me look bad?
Sir, we're terribly sorry, sir. It won't happen again. Please accept our most sincere apologies.
Base Commander Stephen D. Kenny, reporting from Earth, sir.
Ha! A rather leisurely return for the great Earth hero, Lightspeed Kenny, wouldn't you say? It hardly bodes well for the commander of such an important mission to miss his own departure ceremony.
My apologies, Deputy Director Shimada. Truly, I am blessed with a superior of vast kindness and understanding to have been assigned trivial duties at a time like this.
Very well. I leave the rest to you. I'm exhausted, Commander. I had to oversee the ceremony in your place, you know. In any case, the guests seemed pleased. It made for a fine dawn to the age of space exploration.
A number of governmental officials were expected to attend the ceremony, sir. The presence of the commander would have just been a distraction. I'm sure that was his concern.
It doesn't matter. The ceremony is just a formality, anyway. We'll celebrate their departure from here. Yes, their departure.
Alrighty. Okay, the horse to carry to walk, X to sprint. Okay. So yeah, I will be using this. This is the walking. This is the walk. Or this is, oh, I don't... This is how I'll usually run. That's if you want to run fast. But this is Edge. He's your main character. And, he's nothing like the other main characters of Final Fantasy, of this series. Oh, by the way, this is our ship. So, we're exploring our ship. Great. Thing is still down. I guess we won't be meeting her yet. This is storage. I think one of my favorite characters actually stands in here. Or in this one. I don't know. I have like two favorite characters in this game. And they're of the same race. This is going back upstairs. This is the rooms. This is our room with our save. There's like, since I'm playing on easy, there's gonna be a lot of saves. So you will be seeing this, save screen pretty much a lot of times. I think, Rainy stays in here. I don't know who Edge shares a room with. I really don't. I really don't know. There's another save up here. This is the deck. We will probably be in here quite a bit. Can I please talk to her? Thank you. About time, you're late. Are you ready for launch? What is it? Did you forget something? Huh? Oh, let's get going. There's a lot of cutscenes, by the way.
Huh? What's that?
It's Lou!
Ah!
Gotcha! Hey there, kid. It's nice to meet ya. You're Edge, right? Of course you are. You don't have to tell me. Anyway, greetings from USTA headquarters, little old me. The name's Welch. As you can see, I'm a bashful little girl. I'll be the one supporting you from Earth, okay? This'll be fun. Looking forward to working with ya. Cheers! What is it, Edge? What's with that look on your face? Oh, you don't mind if I use your first name? Nah, of course you don't.
No,
Boy, is this one indecisive or what? Yeesh. Hey, you need a good poke in the eyes, is that it? Come here. Poke, poke.
Hey, hold up a sec. Oh, man. I heard each ship would be getting support from Earth. But I never imagined anything like this.
Didn't think your support would be so cute, did you? Anyway, from here on out, I got your back, man. Straight to the fiery depths of hell!
That's really not the kind of thing I want to be hearing before takeoff.
Oh, relax, you'll be fine. Let's see now, your first destination is... Planet Eos, right? Fortunately, the unmanned exploration craft didn't report anything dangerous out there, like giant outer space bugs or whatever. So yeah, no worries, go for broke, Edge!
Is this the kind of support we're to expect, ma'am?
Ma'am? What am I, your mother? We're gonna be together for a while, kid, so let's dispense with the formalities. looks like you got another call. Oh well, enough lover's patter for now. Talk to you later!
Yo, Edge!
I love Edge.
Edge, hey! Don't just cut the transmission like that!
This channel is not for communication with the captain of the Kalnis, sir. Or is there something a common crew member can do for you? Captain Crow F. Almedio of the SRF-001 Aquila?
Pretending to be all dutiful doesn't suit you, Edge. You skipped the departure ceremony, didn't you?
Who cares? It's got nothing to do with you.
Raimi was upset. You really can be a pain sometimes, you know that?
You done?
Look, just don't be too hard on her, okay? Seeing the two of you fight makes your big bro so sad.
We're not actually fighting. And would you quit with the theatrics already? It's really irritating.
Yeah. Hey, come on, Edge. Does it really bug you that much that I made Captain?
Actually, no, it doesn't. In fact, I think it's only natural you were promoted. It's just... you're getting so far ahead of me.
You really haven't changed at all. Still the same kid you were back in school and at the academy. I'm not as far ahead as you might think. There's no need for you to rush yourself.
Goodbye.
Wait a second! Edge. You realize just how important our duties are with the SRF, don't you? Everyone shares the same responsibility, captain or not. Look, we're all in the same boat here. I'm just as nervous as you are.
K- Captain Almedio nervous? What, we expecting meteor showers tomorrow?
This isn't a joke. Look, Edge, how should I put this? Let's both give it our all, huh?
Yeah, let's.
Great. Well, that's all I got for now. Looks like it's almost time. Bon voyage!
Bon voyage? We're going to the same place.
If only.
Oh well. I suppose I can't stay mad forever.
If what they're planning.
Then. Let's get the show on the road.
Edge.
Hands in position.
That's the captain.
SRF-003 Calnus. Initiate launch procedures.
Roger.
So, this is it.
Huh.
Indeed it is.
Here we're going.
We've charged these children
with
the future of our species. Let us salute the departure of our seeds of hope.
001, Aquila, launch preparations complete. 002, Belena to follow.
You've all been trained well. Keep a steady hand and perform as you always have.
The time to step forward is upon us. Brave pioneers charged with the destiny of mankind about to depart for space unknown. I pray for the success of your journey.
Aquila, launch confirmed. 002, Belena, preparing to launch. 002, Belena, launch confirmed.
SRF-003, Calnus, engage!
Yes, sir. Initiating launch.
There's five of them. And of course, we get the blue ship.
Seconds to warp out.
Gravity balance, ship functions, all normal. Prepare for warp out.
Finally, Eos. And I'm gonna be the first to take that one small step onto the surface.
You really are just a big kid, Edge.
Hey, it's a big deal for a guy, all right? An honor.
Edge, be careful to keep the ship stable when we warp out.
Yeah, just ignore me, why don't you?
I don't remember that.
gravity reading. There's a meteor-like object crossing our planned trajectory. But from this distance, I can't confirm any gravity wave interference.
Meteor.
The unidentified object has passed us. I'm detecting some minor fluctuations in the gravitational field.
A meteor affecting our gravitational field? Isn't that strange?
Yeah.
Kalnus, commencing warp out. 10 seconds to warp out. 9, 8, 7, 6.
What the?
What's going on? Status report!
There's a fluctuation inside our wormhole, sir! An abnormal gravity wave is spreading fast! It's producing an error in our subspace flight tracer!
Too late! We can't avoid it!
What?
Captain, interference from the gravity wave is spreading throughout the wormhole. Our planned warp-out point has disappeared! We're gonna lose our navigational coordinates!
Damn! What about the other four ships?
No idea, sir! I'm not detecting them in subspace!
Input a new coordinate axis. We've got to initiate an emergency warp out.
Raimi, I'll handle 3, 5, and 9. You take the rest.
Coordinate axis input complete.
Warp out preparations complete.
Edge!
Everything's ready.
Captain!
Emergency warp out. All hands, brace for impact.
See, I remember the crashing. I just don't remember the mirror. I don't remember that what happened. What caused it.
Damn. Oh.
But I haven't played this game in a long time.
Crash land?
Yes, Edge, you did. Why is it white? Oh.
Where are we?
On the planet you were supposed to land on. Literally. So, yeah. That's like, 20 minutes of cutscenes. Literally. Oh, the mouse does this shit, but I'm not using the mouse, I'm using a keyboard, or not keyboard, this. Oh, let's check on everyone. Ah, he sees fine. If only I've been more careful. He's fine.
Raimi? Raimi! Raimi, wake up!
Thank God we're all safe. At least no one's critically wounded. Let's be grateful for small mercies.
issuing new directives. Status report.
Damage to the ship is severe. The Kalnus is in very serious condition, sir. However, based on my analysis of the data, I can say with confidence that we've arrived on planet Eos.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we made it after all!
Please, continue.
We're not the only ones who crash-landed, sir. I've detected other ships in the vicinity that probably encountered the warp anomaly. The Countess is here. Here's the Belena and Dant de Leon. And the Aramia.
First, let's join the Belena and Dant de Leon crews. Once we're back in operating condition, we'll request further instructions from USTA headquarters. Any questions?
Captain, what do you think happened to the Aquila?
It appears the Aquila attempted an emergency warp out as well, but I'm afraid that's the only information we currently have.
Well, there's your answer on the Aquila. It concerns me, but there's nothing we can do right now. We have to concentrate on the task in front of us. The repair crew should prioritize subspace communication functions. We can't do anything without comms. I need those repairs completed double time, understood?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Maverick.
Sir.
I'd like you to scout the area around the ship and make sure we're safe here.
Yes, sir.
New chapter. Yeah. I'm going for chess. Because we do gain spirits points for finding chests and whatnot. Okay, I found two. There's one over here. Oh, I missed the one right here. Blueberries. That means there's an actual chest. I'm gonna try to collect everything. You guys can't even see my map. I'm over here so you guys can see the map. The next one is over here. And then, okay, get out of the thing. And at the very top over here. Hey, I'm. Where's that egg? Yay, thank you. Oh, yeah. If you haven't noticed, I'm a save freak and we're also out of time. In the next video, we will explore the area more. And pick up harvesting and mining. I think we could pick those up. The stats? No, that's skills. Beat. No, that's other shit. Oh, I probably will not be doing all the side quests. I'll do some of them, not all of them. because I'm going to be focusing more on collecting all of this shit. Oh, yes, Beth, that already. Huh. He has that too. Huh. But anyway, guys, that's it for this part. Leave me a like, comment, subscribe if you have it. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.